Hi, this is Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics. In this video, I would like to talk about the sump tank. So as you know, most of my videos, I show you some setups that are composed of only one fish tank and a growbed. The growbed is basically most of the time sitting on the top of the fish tank. That is the easiest way to build an aquaponics setup because you only need two tanks and it works with gravity. But today, I would like to show you another way of building an aquaponics setup using a sump tank. If you want to start your aquaponics setup, don't forget to get the free guides from the description of the video just below. And that's a six-step process to build your own aquaponics setup. It's 100% free. I just designed it for you to help you to build your own aquaponics setup. So use it. It's going to avoid you a lot of problems if you follow my recommendation. So get this guide from the description. A sump tank presents two main advantages. The first one is that the level of water into your fish tank is always the same, it's constant. You know that in a normal growbed aquaponic setup with composed of only one growbed and one fish tank, the fish tank level is always decreasing and increasing, such as the growbed. It needs to release the water for the growbed, and then when the growbed flush, when the siphon of the growbed flush, the level of water into the fish tank increase. So that's the water level into a normal growbed aquaponics without sump tank is always going up and down several times per day. Using a sump tank allows you to have a constant water level into your fish tank. For example, here we got a setup in a restaurant, so we are still building the setup at the moment, but I just finished this to cycle and to put in place the different components. And what we want, one of the requirements here is to have this fish tank. You see, that's quite a nice fish tank. The water level of this fish tank is always going to remain constant up to the top. The other very interesting point when we work with a sump tank is the fact that you can have your growbed and your fish tank at any level. For example, here they are almost at the same level. You can see that the fish tank here is almost at the same level, the level of water, at the top of my growbed that is just here. That's basically the two main advantages of having a sump tank. A sump tank is also very interesting because here we have the pump, so all the technical equipment of the setup that is placed into the sump tank. So if we have a problem, if we want to maintain the pump or anything, we just have to go into the sump tank, and therefore we are not going to go into the fish tank and disturb the fish. So from this point of view, it's really good, it's better for the fish because you don't have to put your hands into the fish tank, you don't have to disturb the fish, you don't stress the fish at all. You just have to do whatever you have to do into the sump tank, which is a technical area where no fish are living. It's also a really good place to stock some filters. You know, if you want to put a mechanic filtration such as some moss, you can definitely put some moss into the sump tank, and in this case you're going to avoid all the large particles to go and to plug the pump. So you're going to extend the life of your pump, and also you're going to minimize the quantity of maintenance you have to do on the pump, because here you're going to filter the water so you don't have to clean it as often. And the sump tank is also a really good area to introduce the minerals. You know that in aquaponics we need to add some minerals to maintain our plants, our vegetables strong, green and healthy. I made a special video about it. It's a bonus video that you can have from the description of this video here. All the minerals that you need to add into your normal aquaponics setup here. In the classic aquaponics setup, we add the minerals and the iron powders into the belt siphon. So that's where we got a good mix. But in a sump tank, you can directly add the minerals into the sump tank. In this case, you're going to add the minerals, they're going to release slowly into the whole setup, and you are not going to create a big wave of minerals, they're going to dissolve slowly, which is the best. You can also add all your, you know, the eggshells, all those kind of things that you use to increase the pH, you can introduce them into the sump tank. So that's a really good area to place all those minerals and all the fertilizer that you want to use, you can definitely introduce them through the sump tank. So now I'm going to explain you exactly how it works and how you can put it in place in your setup if you wish. The idea is that we're going to have some water in our sump tank. So here, for example, in this setup, the sump tank is on the very bottom. It's very often the case in aquaponics when you go to sump tank. It's often the lowest point of the setup where all the water is going back by gravity. So the idea is to build a setup with a sump tank, but with only one pump, right? That's very important. You decrease the water consumption. You can work with different pumps, but try to minimize it as much as possible, right? You always, if you minimize the number of pumps, you always reduce the power consumption of the setup, which is very important for sustainability purposes. Okay, so behind me is a sump tank. Here, you can see the sump tank, you can see the water level here. In this sump tank, it's just basically a reserve of water, right? So in the sump tank is an empty tank, and there is only one pump into the sump tank. That's the only thing that you need into the sump tank. So here again, you know that I'm very worried about sustainability when I design an aquaponics setup, because I think it's a real purpose of aquaponics. So here I'm again working with a 20 watt pump, which is extremely low. So the pump is here. This simple 20 watt pump is going to supply the whole water flow of this setup. So it's still a very efficient setup. Even if it's inside, we always try to optimize the power consumption of the setup we create at Maintain Aquaponics. Okay, so here you got the sump tank. Now I'm going to show you, I just showed you that there is a pump into the sump tank. So the water that is raised from the sump tank is going directly into the fish tank. So here, obviously, the water is dirty because I just put the water in place and I work with clay balls. If you got my book, you know how to get rid of this dirt without any issue, without any problem, without having to clean all the balls by yourself. The water coming from the pump is coming through this pipe here. There is a little pipe and basically the water is coming into this fish tank. Now, when the water reaches a certain level into the fish tank, it's connected to the growbed. And it comes through this little pipe. So here I just put a little cage on top of the pipe because I don't want the balls to go into this pipe. It will be dramatic because it will decrease the water flow coming into this grow bed. And in this case, it will basically plug the evacuation of this tank. And the water level will increase and it will overflow. So it will be not really good for the restaurant. So that's why we always take, we always put those kind of things in place. So here you got a nice grow bed, you see. And in this grow bed, you got one siphon, a bell siphon. And here I got just an overflow just in case there is a problem. But here I got a bell siphon, and the bell siphon is gonna basically, you see it's on at the moment, and it's gonna allow the water to come back into the sump tank. So that's really how this setup works. Each time the growbed is flushing, you got the water that is falling down into this this tank, and the water level of the sump tank increase. Obviously this one is gonna be empty. The bell siphon is gonna stop, and the pump is always still on, so it's going to raise the water to the fish tank. The water is always coming, so the water level here is going to increase again. And well, that's the principle of a bell siphon, right? It's going up and down several times per hour. I mean, at least twice I want to have the water level up and down per hour. In this case, I got a good oxygenation for my bacteria into the grow bed. So when you design your sump tank, just make sure that you place an overflow inside the sump tank. So by overflow, I mean a pipe that is going inside the sump tank and that is raising up just maybe 5 centimeters below the top of the sump tank. So if the water level is too high, if for some reason someone adds some water into the fish tank, the level of the fish tank is going to remain the same, but the water level into the sump tank is going to increase. So you don't want to have, if your aquaponic setup is inside, if it's an indoor aquaponic setup, you don't want to have the water that overflows everywhere. So in this case, you just put an evacuation in place with the pipe going inside the sump tank and raising up to 5 centimeters below the top of the sump tank. In this case, if you put too much water, the water is going to drop into the overflow and be evacuated, be drained out and not flowing over the sump tank and therefore everywhere on the floor. So that's really how you work with a sump tank. And here you can see this setup is going to be a very nice setup because the customers of this restaurant, it's a really nice restaurant, it's going to be a really nice restaurant, still a lot of work to do. But the customers of this restaurant are going to be able to sit on the table here. I mean, not on the table, to sit on the chairs, to have lunch on the table. And they're going to have the fish tank just near them. And they're going to have the grow bed with some vegetables that are growing in front of them. So they're going to be really in contact with aquaponics. And they're really going to, hopefully, they're going to understand how the system works. I think that's really good to have those kind of things in place because it's really good communication and it really shows people how you can produce food with the waste of the fish. So it's really sustainable, it's in the principle of permaculture, and I think it's a really good project. I'm very happy to have worked on it. On this specific project, I worked with another company who is really specialized into doing some customized tanks. So I worked with them to design the tanks. They built the tank for us, and then we designed the system by ourselves, and we put the belt siphon and everything in place, and now it's running. So we are very happy. And if you are interested, if you want to see the setup, and if you want to come and eat into this restaurant, the restaurant is called the Lilies. It's in Melbourne, in Prahran, very close to Chapel Street.
Webinar specific to aquaponics, I deliver a lot of information. Finally, you are probably aware that I wrote a digital aquaponics manual called The Art of Aquaponics, and you can have access to a free excerpt of this aquaponics manual where I add a lot of value and give you a lot of my knowledge about aquaponics. So don't forget that you can have access to those four gifts on the description of the video, and I'm sure they're going to help you to develop your aquaponics setup and to produce your own sustainable and healthy food in good conditions. Bye bye.
Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!